Hello friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a TBR shelf reorganization slash summer TBR. As you can see from the shelves behind me, I have a good amount of books and a lot of them I have not read yet. So I have made it my mission this summer to try and get through as many books that I own as I can. Now I'm not gonna keep myself to this 100% because I don't want to deprive myself of the love of my library and book shopping. However, I have an issue. So before I sat down to film this clip, I actually ended up just going ahead and reorganizing my TBR shelf and putting my summer TBR over here on my windowsill. I just thought it was a very fun way to get all of my summer TBR books in their own little space and clear up some room on my shelves. So let's go ahead and get into the reorganization. Now that you have seen my newly reorganized shelves, I am so happy with how they turned out, and hopefully it won't be an issue in the future that some of my books that I haven't read are on my favorite shelf. Maybe some of them will trickle their way down eventually. But now let us get into my summer TBR. Let us start with the two books that I am currently in the middle of, and that is Skinny Dip by Carl Hiaasen and A System So Magnificent It Is Blinding by Amanda Svensson. This is for my library and I've been reading it forever. It's quite chonky, but I do want to finish it because I am intrigued. Just not in a literary fiction mood right now, but I know eventually I will be later this summer. And Skinny Dip is a kind of summer thriller set in the Florida Everglades, South Florida area about a woman whose husband tries to kill her unsuccessfully and what happens. I originally bought this from a used bookstore because I absolutely love the cover and just the colors, and I'm really enjoying it so far. Next, we will get into the fantasy books that I want to read this summer. This is probably the biggest category that I have on my summer TBR just because I am really getting into fantasy currently and understanding what I like in fantasy, what I don't like, and so I am trying to explore that a little bit more. So I have five books physically that I have on my summer TBR. The first one, which I have talked about at length in all of my videos, is the second book in the Mistborn series, or The Well of Ascension by Brandon Sanderson. This one is chunky, but I know that this would be a fantastic read just to sit out on my balcony and get through it, or maybe by the pool or something. Again, it is chunky and don't hate on me. The only reason that I got the mass market paperback size is because I got the first one used. It's mass market paperback size, and I need them to be all in the same size. And I absolutely love this series. I know what's gonna be on my shelves, so I just needed them to match. The next fantasy book is the first Harry Potter book. Now, I have never read Harry Potter, and I've never watched all of the movies consecutively all the way through. I generally know what happens, but I've never actually consumed with my eyeballs or earballs. Harry Potter. I found this in a free little library like last year or the year before and figured I would pick it up, and if I enjoyed it, that I would get the box set and then read all of them. So I want to read Harry Potter. I know this is going to be an easy read to fly through, probably in a day sometime this summer. So I want to get through it finally. Next is a childhood favorite. I guess it's kind of fantasy, and that is the next book on my TBR is a childhood favorite that I want to reread when I found it at a used bookstore, and that is The Anybodies by N.E. Boddy. I really don't remember what the synopsis is of this book, and the back just says, "Things aren't always what they seem, are they?" So again, not really a synopsis, but this is why our middle grade, I believe. And again, I know I can just fly through it this summer, and I have wanted to reread this for so long, and I'm gonna do it this summer. Next on the fantasy genre is a book that I have seen everywhere, and I have wanted to read it for so long, and I think cozy fantasy is exactly what I'm going to be in the mood for this summer, and that is Legends and Lattes by Travis Baldry. This book is just... it's everything I need. Like, I don't even, like, just looking at the cover, I know that I'm absolutely going to love it. It is about an orc named Viv who decides to stop being a murderous orc and open up a coffee shop. And nobody here has had coffee before. And it's sapphic. I'm cute. I think this is going to be perfect for the summer because it's low stakes, it's cozy, it is nothing that's going to require too much of my brain cells, and I cannot wait to finally dive into this. And last on the fantasy TBR is Tress of the Emerald Sea by Brandon Sanderson. After reading Mistborn, I have gotten really into Brandon Sanderson's writing style, and I love how he builds, like, how he does his world building and introduces characters. Oh my gosh, really, guys? So I decided to pick this up at the bookstore. I am absolutely obsessed with this cover, number one. But I just love Brandon Sanderson, so I figured this was a great option to pick up. I only have one horror book on my TBR. I'm not a big horror reader, but I am trying to figure out if I like the genre, what I like in the genre, and that is The Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires by Grady Hendrix. I think this is going to be a perfect summer read, especially with the peaches on the cover. I don't know much about this book other than the fact that it is vampires and people trying to kill vampires in the South. So, hopefully, if you've read this and it's a good summer book, please let me know. Next, another mystery. I am in search of some good summer thrillers, so if you have any good summer thriller recommendations, please put them down below. I have been looking for a while. However, another book that I picked up by Carl Hyacin is called Striptease. I primarily picked this up because I'm obsessed with this cover, but it's another Florida set mystery type book. I'm really loving his writing style and the mystery in Skinny Dip right now, so I think this would be another great summer read. Next genre is romance. I love a good just fluffy romance to get me through the summer, and first up is nothing other than Happy Place by Emily Henry. I picked this up in my Come Barnes & Noble shopping with me for my birthday. I will link that video if you are interested, and obviously, it's in summer. So, and the pink and like we're matching, everything is coming together beautifully. So I don't know much about this book. I don't want to know a lot going into it, and that's how it's just gonna be. The other summer romance that I absolutely want to read, but I do not have physically, I'm going to get it on my Kindle from my library, is It Happened One Summer by Tessa Bailey. I have heard so many amazing things about this book, and I have been very reluctant to jump on the bandwagon, but I think that it is going to be the perfect summer romance, and it's called It Happened One Summer. I mean, I think I'm gonna call this the classics genre, if you will. And that book is going to be So Long a Letter by Mariama Ba. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, but I was influenced by this book by Brie, who is Locked Booktician. I will link her channel down below. Absolutely love it. And she was doing a Black Classics series, and the way that she described this book just really sold me on it. It's super short, and I think it's going to be a great read for the summer. You can read it in one sitting. I have a feeling that I'm going to be doing a lot of underlining and highlighting of this. And if I'm in the mood for a classic, I will pick this up. Now, the last genre that I'm going to put on this TBR is nonfiction. I'm a huge nonfiction reader. I love to listen to it. I love to read it physically. This top shelf on my bookshelves, if you didn't see my bookshelf reorganization video, is all of my nonfiction. So I have three currently on the TBR, but I love to just pick up audiobooks and listen to them while I'm working out, while I'm working, things like that. While I'm driving, I have a lot of trips coming up this summer. So the first one is going to be Braiding Sweetgrass by Robin Wall Kimmerer. I was influenced by Allison Pages to buy this book just because of the way that she sold it. It was one of her favorite books of 2022, and I will also link her channel down below. Absolutely love her. And I feel like it's going to be the perfect summer heartwarming nonfiction to read. And just look at this gorgeous edition. It comes with a little bookmark. It's this stunning hardback. Can't wait to crack it open. Next up in nonfiction is Wherever You Go, There You Are by Jon Kabat-Zinn. Mindfulness, meditation, and everyday life. Meditation is something that I am interested in, something that I practice, I would say regularly. I've been off of it, but it is a topic that I'm interested in and a topic that I love to read about. So I found this at a thrift store when I was back home and want to give it a read so I can get back into my mindfulness and my meditation this summer. And the last book on my summer TBR is Finance for the People by Paco de Leon. I am an accountant. If you don't know, I do taxes. I'm a CPA, and I am very passionate about personal finance. It's something that I find very interesting and something that I think everybody needs to learn. We're not gonna get on that soapbox, but I picked this up at a bookstore in DC because I have a beautiful little collection somewhere. I think it's down below, of my personal finance books because it is a topic that I love to read about and I love to find good personal finance book recommendations. So I want to read this summer and be able to recommend it to people or not. So I will read this and let you guys know. And that concludes it for my summer TBR. Again, if you have any summer thriller recommendations or any book recommendations that you think would be perfect for me to read this summer, or if you see any of the books on my TBR that you would love to see a reading vlog for, definitely let me know. I would love to make that for you guys. And I will see you in my next video, hopefully when I'm reading some of the books on my summer TBR. Bye, friends.